building a month before we moved out and found a place to rent, with an option to buy. It was up on a cliff in Palos Verdes. We had a ginormous living room with a spectacular view of the ocean. There was a small two-seater balcony off the living room. Both our bedroom and the kitchen also overlooked the ocean. If you went on one flight, there was G. Eiley's room, the guest room where I was going to set up my drums, and a large room for the pool table and all my little pets. California, get a tan, sweat, swim in the ocean. For the first year there, I bucked off. We'd go to Deb's parents' house every Sunday for a big family dinner. After a few months out there, I felt like a different man. I was actually mellow. I felt good about Deb. I didn't fear that she was sneaking off and fucking Joe Kelly. We were a tight, knit little family. On Friday afternoons, I'd take my sports car down the hill and rent 4 or 5 movies and bring back a couple of shopping bags filled with Chinese food. I didn't miss playing at all. I was a man of leisure. I woke up and went to sleep with G. Eiley. In between, we'd watch TV. During the commercials, I'd go to the kitchen for a snack and grab Deb's ass. Life was pretty comfortable then. We can't do this. We're separated. I protested, but out there, and I had never seen her so distraught. Matt broke up with me. She was crying. He dumped me, and I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm so in love with him. I was sitting there like, should I shoot her or just throw her through the window? My heart was breaking, and she was going on about this schmuck dumping her. But as much as I was pissed off, if she would have said, come back to me, I would have. I was that stupid and still in love with her. Of course, a couple of weeks later, they got back together. It was only a matter of time until I got certain papers. Deb's bad friend Maureen.